Hello students, hope you are well in spite of being confined at your home. Anyway, welcome to the history class of class 12. Today it is our third class and you know we are continuing our first chapter, and that is bricks, beads, bones, the Harappan civilization. And today we shall learn about their seals, crypt and beds. How did they use seals and ceilings? And for what did they use seals and ceilings? They mainly use seals and ceilings to maintain a long distance communication. Why had they maintained a long distance communication? Because in our previous classes, we have learned that Harappan civilization had trade relationship with various foreign countries like Mesopotamian civilization, Sumer civilization, etc. So for that, as they had trade relationship, so they had to send any goods, any bag of goods. Suppose they had to send a bag of goods to any foreign country. At that time, they tied the bag with rope, and on the knot, they affixed seals. And how did they made the seals? They just took a lump of clay. What did they take? A lump of clay, suppose. And of course, the lump of clay must be a wet clay. So as it is wet clay, so if you give pressure on it, so what it will be? Its surface will be flat, and on the flat surface of any soft clay, we can write anything on the surface with a sharp object, and of course we can draw something. So it was done by them. They wrote something or they drew something to give their message to the senders. And also the bag reached with its ceiling intact meant that it had not been tampered with. Sometimes on the ceilings there was also the identity of the sender. Okay, so how did they use seals and ceilings? I hope it's clear to you. Now come to the enigmatic script. How did they use their script, or how did they write their script? Look, Harappan seals usually have a line of writing, probably containing the name and the title of the owner. Here, the term probably I have used. More precisely, I have not used. I have written from your book, means our historians or archaeologists have used. Because it's not a solved matter. Up to now, it is a hotly debated matter that it is correct or not. But they assume or they guess that on the seals, Harappan seals usually have a line of writing probably containing the name and the title of the owner. And what is the second feature of their script? In the seals, there were pictures which conveyed the message to those who could not read. Means there were, suppose it's an Harappan script, suppose it's an Harappan script, and this type of one seals they have made, and they have written something here. They may write something here like this with their alphabet or with their letters, or they may draw something here. Maybe the picture of any animal, maybe picture of any place, anything. To give the message to those illiterate person who can't read or write. Understood? Okay, now come to the third point. But Harappan inscriptions were not very long. These were very short. The longest one contained 26 signs. Signs, why we have written signs? Because they are letters, what we tell in English alphabet, letters. One word is formed by means one or more letter when we put together, then one word formed. Suppose I am writing C, it's a letter, A, it's a letter, T, it's a letter. And by this, you know, we prepared it's a word. That is why they are telling signs, because their signs are not up to now deciphered. What is deciphered? Deciphered means you have to decode any coded language. The process of decoding any coded language. Suppose they have used this type of signs. See, there are more signs, but I have drawn only three. This type of signs. We don't know what it is. Means, look it. You can say, you may think that it is our T. In English language, in English alphabet, this is the letter T. But it's not. What they did call it, we don't know up to now. Means our archaeologists are not sure. That is why they are telling that most of them cannot be deciphered up to now. And their coding language is not decoded up to now. Okay? Okay, come to the next point. Number 4. Writing has been found on the variety of objects like seals, copper tools, rims of jars, copper and terracotta tablets, bone rods, ancient signboard, etc. So nowadays we have papers for writing, but at that time paper was not discovered. So where should they write? They wrote on the upper surface of these things. Understood? Now come to the weights. What is weights? From this term you can understand it's an element which is used for measurement. Okay, this is made of, this weight always is made of stone, which is called chart, and the shape of it is cubical. Okay. And now another point is that the lower denomination of weights were binary and the higher denominations followed decimals. Okay. Now come to the ancient authority. Up to now, we have seen many variations in Harappan society. Okay. Such as their agriculture, their agricultural technologies, their city planning, their drainage system, their production of various artifacts like pottery, seals, weights, bricks, jewelries, etc. We have read. But these huge things, by whom was it organized? This is a $1 million question. By whom? How did they organize all these things? How could it be possible for them at that ancient time? We must think that. Yes. Who organized these activities? It's also a hotly debated portion or question. There are so many arguments. There are so many debates about it. All the archaeologists are not sure about it. Nobody. Some told that there are palaces and there are kings. From where they tell it? Now at Mohenjo-daro, they have found a large building. They thought that this large building is palace, and there they found one statue that is called priest king. They thought that this symbolized that there were palaces and the citizens were ruled by the kings. But there some archaeologists did not agree with it. They said that Mohenjo-daro or Harappa, both these civilizations had a good relationship with Mesopotamia. If we go to Mesopotamia, we can see that there are many large buildings and there is exactly a statue of priest king which we can see in the Indus region. So they said that it's as they were friend, as they had good relationship, so one can copy another. Understood? But really, it's not a settled matter. Various archaeologists said various things, such as some archaeologists said that Harappan society had no rulers and that everybody enjoyed equal status. Others felt that there was no single ruler but several, and Mohenjo-daro had a separate ruler. Yet others argue that there was a single state. Given the similarity in artifacts, planned settlements, etc. But the most relevant and flexible theory is that the entire communities could have collectively made and implemented such complex decisions. But we are not sure about it. I hope you understood today's discussion. Apparently, you may feel that you cannot understand anything if your teachers are in front of you, only then you can understand everything. So, of course, it is expected. But please, my suggestion is that give some time on it. You must watch the video carefully and repeatedly. And of course, you listen the audio also at the same time, very much carefully and repeatedly. And then read the answers of those questions which are provided to you. I hope it will be very easy to understand. Okay. So students, today up to here, the rest portion will be discussed in our next class. Up to then, stay indoors, stay safe and be happy. Love you all, my dear students. Bye.